One of the amazing things that forests do is what I call the miracle of regeneration. Anytime light is allowed to hit the forest floor, anytime space is open in the forest canopy, the forest just manifests a new generation of trees. So what this means is that every generation of trees in the forest is the legacy of a disturbance. And if you can tell how old the trees in the forest are, it'll tell you how long ago that disturbance occurred. So behind me is a white pine, which is a member of a generation of white pines here that are all about 90 years old. So when you have a generation of trees that are 90 years old, that tells you that 90 years ago, something happened to create that generation of trees. In the case of this white pine tree, white pine is a species that grows really well in these old pastures. And so I can infer that 90 years ago, this was a pasture that was allowed to go fallow, and this generation of white pine trees became established here. Where I'm standing now, there's this pocket of yellow birch trees that are all about 40 years old. So I know that in addition to this being a pasture 90 years ago, that something happened 40 years ago to manifest this generation of trees. In this case, I know from historical records that 40 years ago, some of the pine trees in this area are cut, and there's actually a generation of stumps that's about 40 years old. As a side note, 30 to 40 years is about how long it takes a stump to disappear. So these stumps are pretty rotten. If you have something like white birch or aspen in your forest, it's almost certainly the indicator of a large-scale natural disturbance or large-scale logging, something like a clear cut. But because it's yellow birch, what that tells us is that probably just pockets of trees were cut. Yellow birch needs gaps like a quarter acre in size to grow, and so probably some pockets of pine trees were cut that created enough light for the yellow birch. Interestingly, yellow birch is also a tree species that often establishes after logging because it also needs slightly disturbed soils and or dead wood in order to establish. This yellow birch tree is showing us this really neat thing that yellow birch does. Because they're so adapted to grow on dead wood, a lot of times what they'll do is they'll start growing on a stump or a log, and they'll put roots down around it, and then that stump or that log will rot away. It'll just look like the yellow birch has legs. In this case, I can tell that this yellow birch tree was growing on one of those stumps that was created when this forest was managed 40 years ago, and that stump has just rotted away. Here's another yellow birch tree growing on one of those 40-year-old stumps. The other place that we can get a new generation of trees in the forest is not from a disturbance, but from the gradual decline of trees in the overstory. So here at the Catamount Community Forest, there was this stand of white pines that were slowly declining, and their crowns were actually shrinking back from each other and letting a little bit of light hit the forest floor. Because it was just a little bit of light, what's been able to regenerate are some of our shade-tolerant tree species like American beech and eastern hemlock. When you start to do this kind of forensic work in our forest, it can be pretty eye-opening. You know, when we see these forests that have been recently managed, a lot of times you might be like, oh my God, this is never gonna heal itself, this is never gonna look beautiful, this is never gonna be a forest again. And one of the most amazing things about our forests is their resilience. As long as there have been forests, there have been forest fires and floods, natural disturbances of all different types. And what has defined forests is their ability to respond to these things with abundance and resilience. If you like this video, please like and subscribe.